We're going to solve a mixture problem using two variables. Here's a problem. Mia wants to make a punch by mixing some apple juice costing $2.25 per quart with some cranberry juice costing $3.25 per quart. How many quarts of each should she use if she wants to make 100 quarts costing $2.50 per quart? All right, well, I'm going to draw a picture to show what's going on here. We have to mix some apple juice with some cranberry juice. So let's show a picture of what that would look like. Let's say we've got some apple juice. So let's say this is a container of apple juice. And I'm going to put plus because I'm going to add it to some cranberry juice. And if I do add them together, I'm going to have a mix of juice. Okay, now underneath each vat, if you will, I'm going to put how much it costs for that particular vat. Now, we can do this in terms of dollars or cents. I'm going to do it in terms of cents, that way I don't have to worry about the decimal points. But just be consistent. If you do a problem with cents, everything has to be done when you're talking about money in cents, and with dollars, you have to keep it in dollars. So let's say the apple juice costs $2.25 per quart. So I'm going to say this is $2.25 per quart. The cranberry juice is $3.25, and we want the mixture to be $2.50. So at the bottom here, this is representing the unit cost, the $2.25, the $3.25, in other words, how much it is for one quart. Okay, now we're going to see if we know how much is in each. What do we know? Does it tell us how much apple juice we should have in there? No. So that's going to be a variable. So we can let it be any variable we want. I'm going to go ahead and use A, and that'll remind me when I'm done, that's the amount of apple juice. And for the cranberry juice, I'm going to say that's C, certain amount of quarts of cranberry juice, and the mixture. Do I know how much is in the mixture? Well, actually I do. It says I have 100 quarts in this mixture. Okay. We can get two equations from this picture. The first equation has to do with how much apple juice and how much cranberry juice is in the mixture. We're not concerned at all with the cost. So what do we have? We're mixing A, quarts of apple juice, and C, quarts of cranberry juice. And adding those together, I have 100 quarts. So my first equation is A plus C equals 100. See how I did that? I'm only talking about the amount of juice. Amount of juice. So the first equation is talking about the amount of juice. You're going to look what's in each vat. All right, now the second equation is going to be the cost. I want the cost of the apple juice that I use plus the cost of the cranberry juice I use to be the same as the total cost in the mixture. Now to get the cost of the apple juice, you've got $2.25. That's really $2.25, but I'm doing it in cents only, 225 cents per quart, and I have 8 quarts. So the cost is going to be 225A. So in other words, if I only had one quart, it would cost $2.25, and if I had two quarts, it would be $4.50, etc. Plus, how much does the cranberry juice cost? Well, $3.25 per quart, but there's C quarts. So 325C. All right. So if I would have done the mixing of those two, it would be 225A plus 325C. And that's the same price, right? We want it to be the same price as if she just had all 100 quarts at 250 per quart. So that's 250 times 100. So this equation is talking about the cost. Are we okay so far? So what we have are two equations with two unknowns. All right, now we have to simplify this, and then we have to use one of our methods for solving a system of equations. All right, so in the top equation, we have a plus c equals 100. I can either do this by using the addition method where I eliminate the a or the c, or I can use substitution. In the bottom equation, I'm going to simplify it first just a little bit by multiplying the 250 times 100 on the right. So the second equation here, I'm going to simplify 225a plus 325c equals 25,000, multiplying the 250 times 100. And the other equation, a plus c equals 100. Now, I'm going to take that a plus c equals 100, and I'm going to solve for either a or c. All right, so it's up to you which one you want to solve for. So I'm going to take, let's say I want to solve for a, then I would subtract c from both sides. So I'm going to do this by substitution, and remember, that's what I plug in to the other equation for a. I'm going to plug in 100 minus c, right, for a. All right, so let's do that. We're going to take the equation 225, but instead of a, we're going to plug in 100 minus c plus 325c equals 25,000. Okay, so I want you to try this by putting it on pause and see if you could solve for c. Okay, so let's say you're back, let's do it. Minus 225c plus 325c equals 25,000. So I'm going to combine like terms on the left here. I've got 325c minus 225c, that's 100c. And at the same time, I'm going to subtract 2250 from both sides. I'm sorry, 22,500 from both sides. So on the left side, I have 100c. And on the right side, well, what do we have here? We've got 0, 0, 5, I think that's 2500. And if you divide both sides by 100, we get c equals 25. All right, hopefully you got c equals 25 as well. Now remember, if c equals 25, we would go back to our substitution that a was equal to 100 minus c, plug in 25 for c so that a is 75. Now what did c stand for? C stood for the amount of cranberry juice, so I'll need 25 quarts of cranberry juice and 75 quarts of apple juice. The last thing we want to do is see if this makes sense from our original problem. Okay, so remember our original problem and our picture. Remember, A was the amount of apple. Well, now we know A. Let's see if this really makes sense. So instead of writing A in here, I now know that A is the amount of apple juice. So it was 75, right, quarts of apple juice. And C was how much cranberry juice? So that should have been 25. And we still had 100 in the mix. So that makes sense, 75 and 25 equals 100. Let's see if the cost analysis makes the same. Now let's go back to real, you know, dollars and cents here. We've got 75 quarts of apple juice at 225 per quart, right? So basically you're just going to do 75 times 225, get out a calculator, do that, and also we're going to do 25 quarts of the cranberry at 325 a quart. We'll say get out your calculator, see what that is in amounts of money, dollars and cents, add it up, and the question is that the same as 100 quarts at 250 a quart, is what we wanted. Okay, so get out your calculator and try that. Okay, you should have got $168.75 plus $81.25 adds up to $250, which is the same as buying all 100 quarts at $250 a quart, which is also $250. So this is our check. Okay, so what we're doing here is checking the answer, which means that our answer up here was correct, and here it is again. This is definitely the final answer. That's how much we want to use. And that's how to do a mixture problem using two variables. Have fun!